Most people felt anxious at some point in their lives. Sweating starts, the heart beats faster, breath becomes short, you feel chest pain, nausea, stomachache, muscle tension, and dizziness. To understand what anxiety is, we must first look at what is the physiology behind this condition. Once we understand the physiology and become aware of all that is laying beneath this process, we can handle anxiety and trick our mind in order to reduce this feeling of overwhelm. Not completely remove it, but definitely reduce its effects. To begin, we need to further inspect the human brain. Inside, there is a section called the limbic system. It is a set of brain structures which are located underneath the cortex. The limbic system plays an important role in regulating emotions, behavior, memory, and motivation. In particular, it handles fear, which is crucial for our survival. The central part of this system is a structure called amygdala. Besides its function in the cognitive processes and memory, it is shown that amygdala plays a major role in alerting our brain of danger. We can think of it kind of as a brain's alarm. This way, the amygdala sends signals to the hypothalamus, subsequently activating the fight or flight response and the production of stress hormones. If you're not familiar with this, check out our first video where we explain the purpose of a stress reaction. This mechanism helped our ancestors cope with danger. As survival is the driving force of evolution, amygdala developed an extremely sensitive structure. Whether there is a real or a potential threat, it could be activated in much the same manner, preparing your body to react. Sometimes there is no threat, it is just our anticipation of it. However, our body doesn't like to take risks, so the alarm system activates. This is anxiety, the fear of what may happen. In people with anxiety disorders, the section of the brain that controls the threat response goes awry. Whether it is a life-threatening situation or not, you experience the same emotions. Amygdala is overreactive and you perceive every situation as a possible threat. There are different types of anxiety, including generalized anxiety disorder, social anxiety, specific phobias, OCD, PTSD, and panic disorder. It can be caused by genetics, environment, or past trauma. Early life events, especially traumatic ones, can program the limbic system to become overly sensitive. For instance, if you experienced an accident and almost drowned as a child, you may develop a fear of water as an adult. As our survival response, it is very, very fast, leaving no time for logic to come in. As a result, we're unable to think rationally and you feel flooded with emotions. But next time this happens, remember that it is just the way your brain is wired, shaped by evolution for thousands of years in order to keep us alive. Recognizing that it is your survival mechanism reacting and not you, the rational brain, is the first step to managing anxiety. Understanding that it is an independent emotional thinking system which acts without your permission will stop you from criticizing yourself and will help you in turn reduce anxiety. Of course, anxiety can be a lot more complicated as it can require special treatments such as psychotherapy and medication, which is a topic for another video. However, in milder forms, remind yourself you can't really stop your feelings or physical reactions, but you can take charge of what happens next. Calmly tell yourself there is no threat, consciously step back, do not attach yourself to your emotions, and most importantly, breathe. Thank you for watching. Do check out our video on hydration and check out our Instagram page for daily facts on history and science. See you next time.